Guys, AI tech stock is being completely wiped out. Just last night, $1 trillion in market cap was erased. Palantir, down 9%. Oracle, down 5.8%. Advanced Micro Devices, down 5.4%. Nvidia, down 3.5%. Over $1 trillion in market cap, guys, wiped out. Why is this happening? Guys, people are terrified of this AI bubble. But look, you don't just have to take my word for it. Just this week, CEO Sam Altman warned that AI could be in quote-unquote bubble territory. And his company, OpenAI, is valued at $500 billion. It's just crazy. In fact, the vast majority of the S&P is not growing. It's the Magnificent Seven that are holding up all these stocks. And it's kind of wild right now. You see companies like Meta, who have been giving $250 million signing bonuses, are putting a freeze on that. They're stopping the signing bonuses now. And I guess they poached all the good companies, because what you've got right now is you've got a bunch of tech companies, a bunch of AI companies that have had all their top talent poached. They're trying to raise hundreds of millions of dollars in valuation, and the spigot is being cut off. It's pretty remarkable. And this is exacerbated by a report from MIT that just came out, which is wild. Guys, today we're just going to kind of briefly go into why are all these stocks happening? Is the bubble being popped? Is the technology real? And then we're going to talk briefly about what you can start to think about in order to offset these insane changes. All right, that's what we're talking about today. If that's interesting to you, if you want to be keeping up with AI and how it's going to impact you as a man in this new world, if you want to remain relevant, respected, and financially free, smash subscribe, smash the like button. And let's get into it, because I'm coming to you 6 days a week, Monday through Saturday. On Sunday, we rest, boys. That's what we do. We spend time with the family. In any event, MIT just came out with a report titled The Gen AI Divide, The State of AI in Business in 2025. And the reports are pretty staggering. And a lot of the guys in the comments have been talking about this. But this is what they came up with. 95% of organizations investing in generative AI pilots are seeing zero return on investment. In some places, negative. You know, I look back at Klarna, who laid off a bunch of their staff, implemented AI agents, just to realize, oh, this isn't working. This isn't working. So they found that 95% of the organizations are seeing zero return on investment. And that sent investors scared. They also noted that these organizations are spending, were spending $30 to $40 billion in enterprise, and they analyzed 300 public AI deployments. They interviewed 150 leaders and surveyed 350 employees. Hey guys, we covered this a couple weeks ago. One of the things that's happening across the board is companies are laying off thousands of employees, and then they're saying, well, we're using AI. We're using AI now. We don't need to use humans, which we're going to talk about this today, but I record an entire video on this. I'd encourage you to check that out as to what companies are doing when they're doing these layoffs. And they're blaming AI in some cases. Are they being honest, or do they have an ulterior motive? Because the reality is that companies are, and by the way, you guys in the comments are the ones who highlighted and brought my attention to this. So if you bring attention to a topic, if you have something good and valuable to contribute to the conversation, put it in the comments below and I will pin you. If it's a great comment, I'll pin you. At any rate, why are companies incentivized to do this? Well, it attracts more investment. They can put a bigger valuation on their company. You know, if you are an AI tech enabled or you're forward thinking, it attracts investment. At least it has. It also gives you the excuse to allocate more resources, so you can lay off staff in order to allocate more resources towards AI development. You know, in the business world, it doesn't always make sense, but if you can stamp a certain feature on your business, you can get a 4x, 10x multiple on your EBITDA. So in any rate, that's what companies have been doing. Again, that video goes into more detail on this, but this is kind of crazy. And so the question I ask myself here is, well, all these companies are pouring billions and billions of dollars into AI. They're not seeing a return. 95% are not seeing a return on investment. Why? And by the way, just because you're not seeing a return on investment now doesn't mean you won't in the future. You know, when you plant an apple tree, you're not expecting apples within the next 6 months. You might be saying, this is going to provide apples for the rest of eternity. And as I pick more apples, I'll be able to get more seeds and plant more seeds. So I'm just saying that, you know, there's short-term ROI and there's long-term ROI. And one of the problems that you run into in the stock market is investors are looking for short-term ROI. You know, AI, we're going to talk a little bit more about this, but when I think about ROI, I'm not necessarily thinking about what am I going to get today or tomorrow. I'm thinking about what does this look like in 6 months, in a year, in 10 years, etc. And you have to kind of hedge for that when you're investing or building out your own business, your own streams of income. But MIT did kind of highlight why they feel or why they saw that these investments into AI infrastructure was not seeing an ROI. First of which is they did not see it as being a problem with the quality of the AI models, but rather there's a learning gap where these generative AI systems, they fail to retain feedback correctly. They have a hard time adapting to context and complex situations, or it's difficult to integrate them into their workflows. And what happens here is this leads to these like brittle, weak implementations, and then, you know, it just doesn't get adapted properly. And quite frankly, what they found is that most of the users, most of the team members that were using the systems were frankly just preferring using ChatGPT. I mean, they noted that over 90% of employees are using ChatGPT for work just because the interface, how clean it is, how ubiquitous it is. You know, when I talk to people about AI, typically they just say, oh, you mean ChatGPT, or do you mean chat, or do you mean GPT? It's, you know, for whatever it's worth, they've, you know, when you talk about like searching for something on the internet historically, you'd say Google it. Now people are thinking of ChatGPT as AI, which, by the way, brilliant marketing from Altman to accomplish that. The other problem, I think, that organizations, large organizations, you're talking about these large organizations that are spending billions of dollars on AI. The other problem these companies have is that it's kind of like a battleship. It's very slow to turn. You have so many procedures, so many people, so many steps to go through in order to implement change. It's tough to do that with AI because this stuff is changing so fast. I mean, by the time ChatGPT 5 came out last week, Elon's talking about the next implementation of Grok and then Perplexity. And it's like these companies are just are changing and adapting so fast. The other problem is that, you know, ChatGPT 5 came out and they did away with all their old models, the you know, ChatGPT 4.0 and Nano and Micro, and all these old models were done away with. Well, that blows up workflows too, because now the product isn't working the same. It doesn't sound the same. It doesn't feel the same. And, you know, on a webhook, an integration, API integration, sometimes that stuff gets broken. So it's becoming kind of, it's very difficult. Basically what I'm trying to say is it's very difficult for these large organizations to adapt to the change because it's happening so rapidly. I mean, you can look at where generative AI video is today versus where it was at 6 months, first 12 months ago. It has changed crazy amounts. And it's the same thing with these LLMs, okay? So I put this all into context in saying, this is actually a competitive advantage for the small business owner because you can adapt more quickly. You're smaller, you're leaner. If you're a million, $10 million company, you can adapt much more quickly to these new tools. You might, you know, if you have a sales funnel or marketing funnel that's maybe not perfected, you can insert these AI tools into different stages of your funnel to dramatically increase your returns. And you also don't need to train 1,000 people. You might need to train 5 people. You know what I'm saying? So this is a competitive advantage for the small business owner. And I think that's something that cannot be understated enough. So at any rate, it's kind of shocking that MIT put out this report. 95% of these companies are not seeing a return on investment. That is nuts. And it's sent the stocks into a free fall, okay? But I just want to highlight here that just because these stocks are inflated and there may be a bubble, and just because these big companies aren't seeing a return does not mean the technology isn't real. This is not an excuse for you to say, I'm probably safe. I don't need to worry about it. Do not get it twisted. This is not an excuse, guys, for you to go home and watch football and drink beer instead of doing your push-ups, testing out a new model, using ChatGPT, or using Grok, or using Replit. It's not an excuse for you to get comfortable, guys. This is not the time to get comfortable, okay? And just because these stocks are in free fall, just because there's problems with some of these huge organizations, does not mean that AI is not having an impact. And I'm just gonna reflect on several videos or several examples that I've had on this channel that have talked about this. And by the way, if this is interesting to you, if you wanna learn about this topic, if you're a guy who wants to be relevant, respected, and financially free during this AI revolution, I would encourage you to sign up for my newsletter at AIupdate.ai. AIupdate.ai, it's completely free, and I'm able to go into more depth and able to share more stories there that I can't actually get into on the daily YouTube channel. At any rate, I'm going to give you some examples of why I feel that this technology is very, very real for all the haters out there that say it's not real. Netflix just recently, and I recorded a video on this. These are all videos that I've recorded, so I'm just referencing videos that I've already recorded. Netflix used AI recently for special effects in one of their movies. And the director said that it enabled them to create the shot 10 times more quickly and cheaply. AI is going to completely transform Hollywood, guys. By this time next year, there are going to be full-length feature films that are completely AI. You can mark my words on this. It is going to happen. The video is getting so good. So good. I'm not going to go into all the different things that can happen there. But what has happened is that Netflix has used it, they've proved concept, and the director made that quote. Guys, music. You were seeing AI completely take over the Spotify playlist, and I recorded a video on this as well. I'll put a link to it up here. There are songs that are topping the charts, number one on Spotify's playlist, that are 100% AI generated, and the artist on Spotify is a completely fabricated AI artist. That has already happened. They're generating real dollars, real value with AI generated music. McDonald's is using AI to screen applicants for positions. They have, get this, recorded an entire video on this, guys. This is already happening. So don't tell me this stuff ain't real. I almost cursed there. I don't like to curse, but I almost cursed. Don't tell me it's not real. McDonald's has used AI to screen 64 million job applicants. Do you think that might impact the role of HR in a company like McDonald's? 64 million. And as I dug deeper, the whole video, guys, it's up there. As I dug deeper, it's not just McDonald's, it's Wendy's, it's 7-Eleven, it's Chipotle. All the companies are using AI to screen applicants. 64 million job applications just within McDonald's. Don't tell me it's not real. Amazon. You may have heard of them. Guys, Amazon has over 1 million robots operating in warehouses, 1 million AI-driven robots in their warehouses. They are very close to an inflection point where there are more robots in warehouses than humans. So don't tell me it's not real. You know, if your perspective is, well, it hasn't worked in the past, it's not real, it's not gonna work in the future, I'm sorry, that is a cop-out, my friend. And your wife, your kids, your employees deserve better than that. Hard facts here. They deserve better than you sitting back and saying, it hasn't worked in the past, I played with it, doesn't work. Come back to me in 6 months to 12 months, man, because you are putting yourself in a bad position. You're putting your family in a bad position. And my friend, that is not what men do. We look fear in the face. We look the problem in the face. And we take courageous action, okay? Don't tell me it's not real. I just give you four examples of how this stuff is real. So if you say, okay, Mark, I understand. I'm on board. What can I do? Well, I'm gonna go through a few different ideas here real quick. And this I talk about this in just about every video. The best thing that you can do is be curious and adaptive. Be curious about how these tools are impacting your niche, your workplace, your employees, your team. Be curious, adapt. Don't be afraid to adapt. There's a new tool coming out every week, every day. You need to be adapt. You need to be dynamic, okay? Use the tools and don't wait for the smoke to clear. Don't wait for somebody else to figure it out and then you adapt it. There will be stuff like that. But use the tools now. Don't just sit back and say, oh, I've used this in the past, it didn't work, someone else will figure it out. Don't do that. Be proactive, okay? Be curious. Buy assets. Someone mentioned this the other day, and I totally agree with it. Invest in assets, invest in creating different streams of income, because at some point, the role that you're doing might be completely evaporated. And what do? Do you want to start from zero, or do you want to already have some momentum going? Guys, this is one of the reasons I have this YouTube channel. I'm not making a lot of money, but I'm creating some great connections. I'm generating some revenue from the channel. I think last month I made $400, so it's nothing huge, but it's generating some revenue. But I'm connecting with y'all. I'm building up more connections with the community. I'm building some infrastructure of influence. I'm getting emails. I had a call with a guy last week who was going for a job interview and needed some help, and I was able to help him. And I can't wait to hear how that worked out for you, Matt. Let me know. At any rate, don't build up streams of revenue now. Build up ownership and assets now, because it's really hard to predict where jobs are going to be at in the future. And just like I mentioned, kind of like what I'm doing with YouTube here, build your personal brand. Don't wait to be on the breadline to build up your LinkedIn. Build up your network now. Post occasionally on these platforms. Be loud and vocal that you are a forward thinker, that you are dynamic, that you are engaged, that you are adapting to the changes in your industry. Because the people that, I would not hire someone that was too rigid about these tools. I will not hire someone. When I do applications and I'm talking to people, I say, how would you use AI to make your job better? And if their answer is, I don't like AI, I don't use it, the answer is, the interview's over. I can't hire you because you're not adapting to a world that's changing. Cannot do it. So I appreciate you watching the video. Some tough love here for you boys, because I feel like we kind of need it sometime. And listen, if you like the video and if you like to subscribe to all that, that's great. If you like this video, you are going to love yesterday's video, because we talked about what's happening with Oracle. They are laying off thousands and thousands of employees, and Oracle is the largest software company in the world. If not, they're one of. But they're laying off thousands of people, and you guessed it, AI is having a major impact on those firings. So we go into that. It's in some great detail. I know you're going to like it. I know you like this video, and I will see you there. All right, boys, go out. Peace.